The Way in Boxing, The Way in Boxing, as you can see from the thumbnail, Ben Shalom versus Frank Warren. Tension is building, and we're going to talk about it right here in this video. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. It does help with the growth and the visibility of the channel. Thank you to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for another one, because without him, none of this would be possible. And shout out to you, 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 and you. Shout out to each and every one of you that continue to like the content, share the content, comment on the content right here on the platform for all things boxing. Let's get right into it. I don't know if you've seen it, but during the weigh-ins today, it was a little bit of pushing and shoving, a little bit of conversation between Ben Shalom of Boxer and Frank Warren of Queensberry Promotions. Wow. Wow. It seems like Ben Shalom is really, really, really finding a way to get under the skin of these promoters in terms of, because he already had a spat with Eddie Hearn previously. Matter of fact, when they had the press conference for this very fight that we're talking about, they had a spat at the first press conference in the UK where Eddie Hearn had to pull up on Ben Shalom and had a conversation with him, because Ben can be a little sneaky, a little sly with the things he says. And Ben is not really into the fighting. He's just into like winding up. You know what I mean? Anybody he gets a chance to wind up. He did it with Clarissa Shields. He wound her up a little bit, said some things that was controversial. Don't forget, when Fabio Wardley was supposed to fight Frazier Clark the first time, they had a purse bid scheduled. A purse bid was scheduled 1 hour before the purse bid. They pulled out of the fight. They pulled out of the purse bid, and therefore that fight wasn't going to happen anymore. And obviously that rubbed Eddie Hearn the wrong way. And he couldn't wait for the opportunity to talk to Ben Shalom face to face about those said things. And it took Ben a long time to get into the Riyadh Season fold, because a lot of people wasn't really interested. They weren't excited. They didn't like the way that Ben Shalom was going about doing his business as a promoter in the UK, the new promoter in the UK. And so, you know, he was frozen out a little bit, so on and so forth. And here we fast forward. Ben Shalom is getting in with another promoter, because him and Frank Warren got into again, fair use. Shout out to Fight Hub TV, Marcus Vegas. Shout out to Marcus Vegas for this video here that I'm about to show you. This is from Marcus Vegas, Fight Hub TV. Fair use. I'm sourcing it. Marcus Vegas, Fight Hub TV. This is his video that is on X that I'm showing you right now. The little back and forth between Frank Warren and Ben Shalom. So as you can see here, here goes Frank Warren. Push Ben Shalom. Like, you standing in the way. Why are you getting all up in my way? Why are you getting up in my way? You understand? Because you don't forget that Frank Warren was the reason why Riyadh Season is even started, because it started with Francis Ngannou versus Tyson Fury. And a year later, here we are where Ben Shalom gets to have four of his fighters, Ben Whitaker, Chris Eubank Jr., Frazier Clark, and he has another fighter that is on the card as well. So he's getting an opportunity to see it. So, you know, they must forget that Frank is a little bit of a gangster. You can't be playing with Frank Warren like that. So you got a bit of pushing right there. Now, I personally agree. Ben is supposed to, you know, be with his fighter, but you can't push out Frank Warren. And Frank was not having it. And as you can see here, after they shook hands and whatnot, Frank had to pull him aside. Frank had to tug him aside. Let's have a little talk, Ben. Ben, what you saying? Look at me in my face. Why are you pushing me and blocking me out the way? You can see everybody's face in the back. They're like, Ben Shalom holding his hand like, oh my God, you're talking to me. Frank is having none of it. Watch out. Watch out. Don't forget, I brought you on this, man. I gave you the opportunity. All right? Cut that out. There you have Spencer Brown just trying to calm down Frank Warren. So obviously you can tell the tension is building. Frank had enough of Ben Shalom and his little sly behaviors. And, you know, at the end of the day, you got to share the platform. The platform has to be shared between them all. And shout out to Marcus Vegas again of Fight Hub TV for that video. Sourced on Fight Hub TV is where I got it. I'm sure everybody that was in Riyadh Season got a clip of that. But shout out to Marcus Vegas and his whole team at Fight Hub TV for the content that we are definitely here talking about right now. And if they don't know, Frank Warren got shot already in the UK. Frank Warren is not one. Chris Eubank Jr. had a few things to say about Frank Warren. Frank Warren immediately said, who are you talking to like that? I'm about to sue you if you don't take back your statement. And obviously, Frank said a few things defending himself, and he had to also apologize as well. So apologies went on both sides. But Frank is holding everybody accountable to their behavior. And you got to respect that. You got to respect that. He's the big dog in the game right now. He's been doing it as long as Bob Arum and Barry Hearn, who's on the sideline now because Eddie Hearn is taking over, and Don King. He's been around that long. So he's the OG of the OG, the Hall of Famer promoter. So he got to put the young buck in his place and remind him that the reason why you're on Riyadh season is because I told His Excellency Turkey LL Sheikh, yeah, call Bank, because he got a few fighters that I'd love to have on this card. Let's see what goes on tomorrow. Let's see if there's any conversation, any apologies, and whatnot. But Ben Shalom has really got to figure out a way to be more friendly, to be more inclusive. And just remember, yeah, don't bite the hand that is providing you the opportunity. Yeah. The hand that's providing the opportunity for your fighters to fight on such a huge platform in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. So it's wrong on both sides, yeah? Ben shouldn't have stepped in front of Frank Warren, but Frank Warren also shouldn't be pushing Ben aside, especially when his fighters, are doing a face-off, and you know all promoters got to get into the picture because it's good for business. You guys let me know in the comment section, do you see the beef? The beef is going on between Ben Shalom and Frank Warren. It was between Eddie Hearn. Eddie Hearn has put that aside. They've buried that. So let's see. But I love the fact that Frank Warren has held Ben Shalom accountable to his actions. And he called him up on it in front of the whole entire world. Because the world was watching the weigh-in for Artur Beterbiev versus Bivol. And everybody got to see the pushing and the shoving between these two fighters. We got a sensational fight card taking place in Riyadh season from top to bottom. First of all, the co-main event and the main event is going to be firefights. Reason why? The co-main event is this rematch. The first fight was fight of the year. I'm talking about blood, sweat, and tears. They put it all on the line and they're about to do it again. And that leads into the biggest fight in boxing that we've been waiting for outside of the undisputed bout at the heavyweight division. This is definitely the biggest fight that the boxing world has been waiting for, which is Artur Beterbiev versus Dmitry Bivol. And we get it at Undisputed. Beautiful. Beautiful. We also have some other fights on the card. Chris Eubank, like I said, is on the card. He's going to be taking on Camille Serramente, who's a former world title challenger to Gennady Golovkin. We also got the first women's world title fight on this card, which is Skye Nicholson, the WBC champion, taking on Raven Chapman. We're talking about boxer versus pressure. Then we got Ben Whitaker, the fast rising light heavyweight sensation. Entertaining is what Ben Whitaker do. He entertains. They call it showboating. I call it entertaining. We pay hard-earned money to watch these fights, and we want to see some entertainment. And he's 8-0 in his career. He's taking on Liam Cameron, who has done well in his career. He had to battle back, fight some demons, got suspended for recreational drug use, and now he's back. He calls himself the Sheffield Beterbiev. In other words, he punches hard because we know Beterbiev, 20 fights, 20 knockouts. So he'd be knocking people out. So we're talking about boxer versus puncher. Great stylistic matchup. You got Jai Apatia versus Jack Massey. Styles make fights. Another great fight in the cruiserweight division. Listen, boxing fans, listen. This fight card here is tremendous and I can't wait. But we don't want to see Frank Warren or Ben Shalom suiting up no gloves. We don't want to see no fight between none of them. Nah, we ain't trying to see that. So I hope they let that go. I hope they bury that, sort it out, talk about it, whatever they got to do. But that's not good for TV. Jump in the comment section. Let me know if you agree or disagree that Ben Shalom and Frank Warren, yeah, they need to cut out. They need to lower the tension. Let's not let the tension build, but let's the tension decrease or digress. I appreciate y'all. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. And I'm going to catch y'all on the next one. Don't forget, live stream, live watch along. Yeah? Live stream, a watch along. Jump in the chat section for Artur Beterbiev versus Dmitry Bivol. The whole entire fight card. I'm going to be calling the whole entire fight card right here on the Weigh In Boxing. Smash that like and subscribe button. And I'm definitely hoping to see you in the chat during the live stream for the watch along for this fight. Peace and love. I'm out. It's the way in. Call up and you're waiting. Now we get to talk about everything you're saying. Analyzing topics, dropping knowledge. We ain't playing. When you think it's about to end, should we crank it up again? Hold up.